That's our makeshift scarecrow. Help keep the raccoon out of here. Plus, the pumpkin that was growing out of that grass, or that got in the grass, got real high. The stem had got busted. That broke coming up out of the ground. They said, my wife said, it looked like it had was getting root rot, and it was dying off. So we just pulled it all the way up, and we've got it encircled around the bottom because of the hairs that are on the stem will aggravate the raccoon. You know, they don't like touching that, so we just put that all the way around. As you can see here. God, that corn, the pollen on that corn smells really strong and sweet. You can see a few ears of corn in there. Look like they're about ready. But yeah, see, look how high the grass is there now? The pumpkin was down right about there. And it came up and went out that way. Because we had pumpkins on there. There were small ones, but you know, about 3 pounds. But the leaves all look wilted and everything, and what it was the extra stem coming out of the ground was broke. So we just pulled it all the way up and got it going around the base of the corn out here. Yeah, but this stuff smells really sweet. This right here is the pollen. It comes off of here. Like if you shake it, you'll see like dust coming down. And that's what pollinates the ears of the corn, because it's like, you know, bright yellow corn hairs. Ouch! Oh God, my knee! It's like that right there, yellow. And then it gets like this, and then when it gets like this right there, that should be about all fertilized. Each one of those hairs is a kernel of corn. So there's another one in the back there. It's a bigger one, but we might get about 12 ears of corn out of here. So. See these beetles right here drive me. These are the Japanese beetle. Damn things. I was spraying them earlier, about a month ago. And they kind of got out of here. But yeah, we're probably going to only get out of 40 plus ears of corn. I mean, stalks of corn, we'll probably get about 20 ears, if that. Because of the ones that you just look in there and see that. How they. Raccoon got in here and tore it up. It was eating the ears. I got them all stocked over there by my fire pit thing. My guard is all messed up here. We've got 6 giant bulbs in the house that we grew from November last year. All the corn over there, the stalks, and see that ear of corn right there like that? Raccoon got that. I just left out there. Figure if he come back, he can just get that stuff and stay away from the garden. But that's our little makeshift scarecrow. And then the pumpkin vine going all the way around it. It irritates their paws and whatnot. So. Plus, now, like I said, I got this row right here and that right there. There's 4 or 5 here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 because the 5th one broke. 4 stalks here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14. About 18 stalks of corn. Still growing strong. Plus, I've got these others. I probably got about 8 to 12 years of corn to get off the first 4 rows. So, there you go. Here's our scarecrow. Ooh, it's going to look like a guy because they got that spotlight right there. Solar spotlight's going to shine on it. And from the house tonight, we're going to look out here and we're going to see that thing with a light shining up on it. Funny.